guys, what is up? Welcome to another episode of Maximilian Must Know. Today we're looking at a fragrance called Photo from the house of Karl Lagerfeld. It's the first review that I'm doing from this house, and as always when we do a review from a house for the first time, got to talk about the brand a little bit and give some context. Let's talk Karl Lagerfeld. Lagerfeld was a German-born designer who based his business out of Paris. He's been pretty secretive about his life, but it's believed he was born in the 30s and got started in fashion mid-50s and had an apprenticeship at Balmain. Eventually, he moved on to houses like Jean Patou, Chloe and Fendi, and in 1983, he became creative director at Chanel. Big deal, obviously. Stayed with him until 2000. Also created his own collection in 84, designed for until 1997. He's done very successful collaborations with Diesel and H&M. I remember the first Lagerfeld, I don't have any pieces from it, but I have pieces from many H&M collaborations, from Victor and Rolf to Versace to Balmain. But I remember the Lagerfeld one. I didn't really like anything from it. I was lucky enough to live near a flagship and get shit, buy shit, but I didn't really love anything from the Lagerfeld, but I remember that broke shit, you know what I'm saying, when he did his H&M collab. Also had his fair share of controversy. He's been accused of being fatphobic, and he used to be a big dude. He lost 93 pounds in 2001. He's been accused of being a racist, which is obviously now, I mean, if you're accused of being a racist in 2020, you might as well have, you know, fucked and murdered a two-month-old. And he's been and I'm not a racist, by the way, and I don't, you know, reject anything that's racist, but it's all relaxed. And he's been accused of opposing the Me Too movement. He was a big, you know, he had some shit to say about that as well. He's had his shit to say, basically. Fragrances have been available under the Karl Lagerfeld name since 1978. Lagerfeld Classic for Men was first launched. His women's fragrances, Sun, Moon, Stars, was an iconic and hugely successful fragrance of the 90s. Today, Karl Lagerfeld fragrances are produced either in collaboration, are produced in collaboration with Tommy Hilfiger. 28 fragrances exist in the catalog, the earliest 1975, the latest 2019. I'm sure you already know Karl Lagerfeld passed away not too long ago, recently actually, this year or last year, I believe, from pancreatic cancer. Boy, that is a motherfucker too, because, you know, I'm like, we can do a whole other video about health if you guys are interested in it, because I'd love to talk about it, but that's the one that really scares me, because it's so impossible to screen. Alex Trebek, so many people, Patrick Swayze, anyway, RIP Karl. The other fragrance that I'm interested in from this house is Lagerfeld Classic, which was introduced in 78. It draws some comparison to Guerlain Heritage, so I'm super interested in that one, and probably will wind up with a bottle at some point. I know it's usually on sale on the internet, you know, so I would say it will make its way into my collection at some point. This guy, Photo, I got my 125ml bottle for $15 from TJ Maxx. It is the newer formulation, not the vintage. But it looks like now, if you want any formulation of this one, you're gonna pay over $100. And sometimes well over it, as it looks like the scent was either discontinued or all stock was bought up after his death, so it's a hot commodity. The aftershave I see readily available, the EDT not so much. Originally a 1990 release with notes of aldehydes, lavender, mandarin, orange, bergamot, galbanum, lemon, cyclamen, coriander, honey, carnation, jasmine, rose, caraway, sandalwood, tocamine, amber, patchouli, musk, benzoin, oak musk, guaiacol, cedar woods. Bottle has this like thing on the top. I don't know. Maybe it's supposed to look like a camera lens. That would make sense. Lagerfeld Photo. Sprayer. I'm just going to spray some of it on my arm. The sprayer is kind of boof. If you look. Not horrible, but you see the noise? I don't like when they do that. The OG bottles Instead of saying Lagerfeld photo here, they have like it written in like digital print, like the kind of green, like a neon green, and the kind of print you'd see on like the back of a camera where you're taking, like on the Finder. It just looked like a photographic digital font. And that was different, and the fragrance was different. And I know that because I smelled this for the first time in like 92, 93. See, I talk about how, I had a friend, I don't think he watches these, but his name was John Haruda. He's on my Facebook, he's my man, my best friend. He put me on so much shit when we went to grade school, grammar school together. Starter jacket, Tommy Hilfiger, Ralph Lauren, cross colors, a lot of hip hop shit. I put him on the hip hop shit. And he put me in Fahrenheit, which was the first fragrance I ever loved. He put me on the Gray Flannel. He fucked with Gray Flannel. And I remember one time he didn't have Fahrenheit, but he smelled good one day. And I was like, yo, what is that? He had a mini sprayer of this shit, of the OG photo. And I just, something about it, just, I loved it. And I didn't know anything about the notes or anything like that, but I can talk a little bit to it now because I bought a bottle after that, back way back, like 92. And I'll say this, people who love Big Men's aldehydic lavender scents are going to like this one because exactly what you get with this one. It's soapy, it's over the top, there's a ton of aldehydes at the top, big whack of lavender, there's some spicy carnation, it's just like, it's aromatic, citrus, oak moss, big green, soapy. One of those perfumes was just too much going on here. There's honey, there's florals, there's citrus, there's exotic notes. Just like a real classic men's alhidic scent. Really, to me, really a less impressive, less impressive version of something like Pico de Adama by Zerzhov, which I mean as a compliment because that's very expensive, one of my favorites. It's not too far off, you know, clearly made with less expensive material, but just a beautiful 90s masculine fragrance that dries down to like wood, musk, amber, and tonka. Really nice, dated as fuck, but just still so nice in this space. And if you love this kind of scent or just a fan of Karl Lagerfeld, big time, can't miss. Performance is fine in this one, but it has lost some oomph in the reform. It's just not as rich as I remember. And I remember this one lasting all day, blue pill style. Now you're probably looking at 5 to 6 hours with this. I'd say it's a classic men's scent, but of course you have to wear what you want. And I think this is the Four Seasons scent. Ideally, this is a scent you want to wear 1 to 2 sprays of to work in the springtime. You don't want to overdose it because it's somewhat dated. If you're looking for something similar, look, this is very unique to me. Pico de Adama is really one of the only fragrances I can think of that smells like this. And it's not fair because Pico de Adama, like, literally shits on this. It's just a masterpiece, aldehydic men's fragrance. And some people think that's a woman's fragrance, to be honest with you, and I could see that. But I can't really draw too much anything that I've smelled otherwise that, you know what I'm saying? A little bit, but it smells like tobacco by Mortimer and Witz, which is a shaving scent. It has aldehydes and lavender, but it's just really hard for me to compare. You know, I'm not a big fan of masculine fragrances with aldehydes. So it's kind of hard for me. If someone trying to talk you into purchasing this, I think they'd say collector piece now, obviously. Will there be more Karl Lagerfeld fragrances? I don't know. We'll see. So maybe buy what you can. I think it smells good. And for some people, it's going to have a nostalgic value. I think on the flip side, it's going to be expensive now. Probably it's going to be hard to find. And this is going to smell dated. If you are a fan of like Sauvage and Versace Duo Blue and YSL Parfum and all that bullshit, and I'm not saying that's bullshit because it's not good. No, I'm not saying that actually. Let me be fair. I'm just saying that it's just very different. This isn't going to be a safe blind buy. You probably won't like this. Overall, I'm gonna give this a 7 out of 10. It would be a higher score actually if I had the vintage version. which is a phenomenal scent, but this is pretty good. A good example of an aldehydic fragrance that works for men. I'm also not going to lie to you and tell you it's something I reach for every day, but it's a good solid scent. If you're a collector or love the OG and are wondering if you should get this version, I would tell you I'd only pay a premium for the OG. But if you ever see this version for the Lolo, you definitely scoop it. You know, you could either probably make some dough on it, or you might enjoy it if you like this kind of fragrance. So that's it, guys. That's my review of Photo by Karl Lagerfeld. Please let me know what you think of this one, and what you think of the brand. I would love to know that. Leave a comment in the description. I'll see you guys again real soon with more video. You
going down for the third time. You came and saved me, dear.